Check out that catfish.
Are you freaking kidding me right now?
What is going on, guys, and welcome back to another John Boat to Bass Boat conversion video. So in the last video, we got all of this wired, but now we need to make a box for the switch panel to sit on. So first things first, I'm going to make a template for the box. I need to make a cutout in this cardboard that fits perfectly around the outside of these switches. All right, so this is just a piece from the old bench that I'm going to use for this box. I need to put the battery back in here and see how much room I have for the box. We're gonna need a lot of wire management in this box, but we will do it. So I just wanna put the box like, I think that's a good height for this switch panel right here. So this switch right here is a USB port. So to plug a USB in, it sticks straight up. So I wanna put this low enough in the box to where that USB port isn't getting hit by the lid or anything like that. We gotta keep that in mind. And that should be good. Okay, so I'm going to be keeping the sides the same as the switch. And then I extended out the front and the back 3/4 inches. So now we can go ahead and cut out this square here. Now we can put this back on and go ahead and mark the holes. Okay, so I got all the holes drilled and I got this side already riveted together, but on this side I need to attach some angle. I'm going to stick it on this side, and then that is how I'm going to attach the wall on this side. All right, got this piece cut. Let's go ahead and drill out the holes. All right, so now we got the switch panel attached to the faceplate. It is all riveted together, and we got this piece over here on the side, piece of angle, and there is a lip right there on that piece of angle that sticks out, and that is so this wall will be flush with that, just like so. Now that we got that attached, we need to attach 3/4 inch angle to this wall. I just notched out this corner of the angle, that is so it sits nice and flush up against that piece there. All right, y'all can actually see now. Sorry about that. But we got this all cut out. All right, I'm happy with that. Let's mark the holes. All right, so now we got that side and this side all attached. You're probably wondering where the hell I'm going with this, and I will show you right now. So we got a wall on this side, a wall on this side, right? So this is gonna go down all the way, piece of angle, go down all the way. So we'll have two walls, and then I'm going to put a piece of angle and attach it to this wall here. So they'll have a lip right here, and that is where this side is going to sit. So that side will sit on that wall, attach it there. That will support the back side, and then these two walls will support the entire box. And then we'll have all this space back here for all that wire. On this side, I will have to cut a little loop into the wall. That is for the wire to run out of. I totally forgot I need to cut this corner out, and that is to go around this wire right here. So it's butted up against the wall on both sides. But let's see how high I want this. I'm thinking maybe flush with the top of the fuse block. Oh, by the way, I decided I'm moving the fuse block over 1.5 inches, just to space it out perfectly in that gap. All right, 8.25 inches exactly. There are the two sides attached. Of course, I still need to run the 1-inch angle inside here just to make it all strong. All right, there is the box all supported. Dude, that came out pretty freaking good. I'm stoked with that. So I got the fuse block moved over, and now we can go ahead and place the box in just to get an idea of where this piece needs to go. All right, so there is the box in place, and once again, I freaking love it. Ah, looks so clean. Dude, it looks so freaking good. Once I add the foam to that, it's gonna look amazing. Hopefully we'll be able to shove all these wires inside that box and kind of hide them as well. All right, so I'm pressing this up against the wall and leaving a little line on the back side of this foam. Dude, I cannot get over how good that looks. Leave a like for that box. That is perfect. Okay, so I got all the holes drilled for this piece here. I riveted in the middle one just so it stays in place, but we still need to do the outside ones. Now we need to go ahead and add foam to the box. Make it all pretty. All right, we got some leftover pieces of foam here. Okay, so I just traced out this piece here, and I'm gonna have to install this piece of foam once it's in the boat. All right, there it is, all foamed besides this piece. So we are now ready to attach it, get it in the boat for good. But now we need to wire up these switches. So we got all these wires that are in here, and I have all these numbered, by the way. That one's number 3, just so I know which is which. You have to keep track of everything, all your wires. If you don't, you're not gonna have a very fun time wiring your boat. Last one. Whew. All right, we got all those connected. Now we need to run all these wires right here from these wires down to the fuse block. Cue the time lapse. I just got all the wires connected to the switch panel here, and you can see I taped it all up here. That's just to make it cleaner going through the hole. I still need to attach all the ring terminals, but we can do that once the box is in place. All the wires will be coming out through the side, and it just needs to go right there. But yeah, it's time to put the box in place. Can y'all see? I'm sorry. It's not easy to film and do at the same time. I need a freaking filmer. I need a filmer and an editor in my life. I'd be a lot happier, I think. Oh, dude. Check it out. God, that's so much wire. All right, it is time to officially rivet this box into place, and I'm hoping that these three rivets are enough to hold this box down. All right, the box is riveted in place. Not gonna go anywhere. We can go ahead and attach this last piece of foam. All right, there it is. There is the switch panel box installed, and I must say it looks freaking awesome. We have access to all the switches here. All right, so now that we got all of that, to finish our circuit, we need to add all of these positives and one negative to the fuse block right here. So I'm gonna start with that negative. Wherever it may be, we gotta find it. So this negative is the power wire for the switch panel. All these wires here are the fish finder and battery charger wires. That's why they're all draping over the side, just because it connects to the battery. We're running low on space in this box. It is getting a little hectic in here. Before I attach the wire, I need to make sure I have it marked down. So, switch panel. All right, now we have the fun job of matching up all the positives to where they need to go. First wire attached. So here are all the stickers for the fuse block and the switch panel. We're gonna go ahead and get all new stickers put on. And these things come with some of the stupidest stickers, by the way. If you never ordered any of these, it's like, what is all this? A trumpet with an R? Does that mean anything? A snowflake, a propeller, a bunny, a beer? We're gonna take all these off and put new ones on since we have them. Updating stickers, yeah. This is pretty much just to tell you what fuses what on the fuse block. Now we can, let's go ahead and get this number 6 wired hooked up so we can say we're done with these little stupid screws. So I was just using this little battery to test out all the connections, and I plugged it into this big battery. And check out how bright these interior lights are. Boom! They're like probably 5 times brighter. Holy crap, man. This thing is gonna light up big time. That is awesome. This battery only pushed like 8 volts. It's running at 11.5. So yeah, that is insane how much brighter these lights got. I'm happy. Boom. So I'm just testing all the switches, making sure everything works. I got all the wires connected to the fuse block. I even went ahead and put in some fuses. And everything seems to be working. Everything that is wired up, at least. What else do we got wired up? Back anchor light number 5. Back anchor light is on. Off. On. Off. On. I think that's all we have, bilge pump. So that's not good. There's a problem with the bilge pump. Uh-oh, why isn't the bilge pump working? Look, these LEDs are so bright, they're lighting up these golden dark stickers. That's pretty funny. Okay, so I just mentioned that the bilge pump does not work. Turn on the switch and nothing. And this wire goes to all the interior lights. And I was messing around with this and I touched it to the base of the boat with no paint. And the bilge pump turns on. And I was like, what? The lights are turning on too because it completes the circuit without the switch. And I totally forgot you have to ground the freaking bilge pump. So I just had a whole little fiasco with grounding the bilge pump. At first I realized I needed to ground it. And then I was like, okay, I'll stick a piece of aluminum up here, attach the wire to that, and that will ground it. Kind of like this, since that's what I touched it to and it started working. But then I was like, you know what? This screw right here is going through the wall.
so that could ground it. So I was like, I'll do it on this screw down here.
And did not have a good connection, I guess. It wouldn't turn on.
But I figured it was the paint on the screw not getting a good connection with the ground wire. So then I was like, okay, I got some self-tapping screws that aren't painted, and that is what finally worked. So I got a self-tapping screw right here. The ground wire is connected to it. The ground wire goes down and behind all these negative wires and connects to that.
And now, our bilge pump works. Thank you, Lord. Everything is working perfectly now. Good deal. I'm happy. The wiring is finally all set up. Of course, I still have to connect all the electronics up front, but we can now move on. All right, so it is the next day. I stayed up pretty late getting all these wires connected, but everything is connected, and now everything works. I'm freaking stoked, man. So freaking stoked. But now I get to clean up all these wires, do some wire management, make it look nice, because this is not acceptable. It cannot stay like that. So I'm gonna work on doing that. I need to find a spot for the kill switch, and of course these bus bars as well. But that is going to be it for this video, guys. Ah, man, the battery should be here today. Actually, we'll get the battery today. We can drop it into place. We can get all these wires here that go straight to the battery connected, and then we will be done inside this box. It will take some time getting all these wires cleaned up, so I will show you all the finished product in the next video. I just checked my Amazon and it shows that my lithium battery is out for delivery right now, so it can show up at any time. But guys, I hope y'all enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will catch y'all in the next one. Peace.